is called Annabelle, but really the protagonist's name is, at the beginning, Wayne. When he is born, he's born in a hunting culture, a trapping culture, a very masculine culture in Labrador, Canada. It's north, it's remote, it's wild. But he is intersex, he's hermaphrodite, and his family hides this from him and from the whole community. It's a secret. So the book is about how Annabelle is the secret personality inside Wayne. Wayne's father is called Treadway. In English, that would be it means walking a long way, and he's a man who walks through the woods, the forest, he hunts. He's, at the beginning, he's not sympathetic to the feminine nature of his child. He wants to annihilate it out of love, because he thinks that will be good for the child to be not ambiguous in life. He's afraid. But as the book progresses, the father becomes much more sympathetic and understanding to who his child really is. He changes. I did not know when I was writing it that this would happen, but the character taught me and surprised me while I was writing the book. I chose initially because a friend told me about a child who was born this way. I found it haunting. Affected me. I wondered deeply what must it be like to have such a life. My daughter began studying at university gender studies, and she coincidentally began studying intersex and hermaphrodite, and she sent me all of the medical papers and a lot of information, so I was able to combine facts and research with the heart and soul and imagination of the character. I've always loved Heinrich Böll, and I've always loved the films of Pasolini or the work of Catherine Mansfield from New Zealand. People who have compassion and insight into point of view. Sans jugement, people, artists who try to understand why does someone behave the way they do. It might seem unreasonable or even evil or unwise, or it might seem wonderful, but why? And I like to have a sympathetic understanding of humanity. So the writers and the artists that I love are people who also have that mission. I really love the work of Lisa Moore. Elle est terneuvienne comme moi. Her language, I don't know how it's translated into French, but in English, it's like you took roses and pomegranates and stars, and you squeezed the juice out of it, and you threw it at life, and you flew through it, and you were a bird. That's what it's like in English. And she's so alive. I wish I could read it in French. Maybe one day I will, to see if this quality comes through in her work.